Good afternoon and welcome to Donnybrook for this afternoon's Ireland Women versus Italy Women RBS Six Nations fixture. It may be marked, but I'm in August company, joined as I am by Fiona Coughlin, 85 times capped, former Irish captain, former Irish sportswoman of the year. Fiona, it's a fairly revolutionary selection by Tom Tierney today. How do you interpret it? He's got 8 personnel changes and 3 positional changes.
Yeah, he's looking to obviously build depth in his squad, looking towards next World Cup. I suppose in his eyes the championship was lost when we didn't win against France and England, so he's looking to blood those new players. It'll be interesting to see how they get on, because in a couple of areas, the back three, you know, there's obviously Ali Miller on the wing, but she hasn't played a 15s game in a year, so there is a little bit of a lack of experience there with 2 new caps as well. Likewise, the 8, 9, 10 is very new combination as well together, so it'll be interesting to see how they come together.
Yeah, it's a smart start for Ireland, but they've conceded a penalty there for not releasing the ball in the tackle at the ruck. So an early opportunity for Italy to, it's too far out to kick for Rigoni, but sure she goes for the corner or as close to it as she can. Ooh, and just about bounces that in. I'd be a bit disappointed not to have covered that.
Yeah, so Italy have lost their normal kicker in 10, Veronica Schiavon. She's out injured at the moment, so Rigoni moved into 10, but it seems Solari has taken over the kicking duties.
Yes. So an early opportunity for Italy to apply some real pressure. Camerano to throw in here. Goes to the middle, that's well taken. Camerano again at the back of that. Italy get a good bit of momentum now. Closing in on that line, and that's the Irish defence in disarray. Sophie Spence taken out the scrum half. And it's the prop going around the short side. That's a very good defence. Again, by the team waiting. The throw forwards go around the edge and they're closing ever closer. Right on the line now. But it's held up by Ireland. Good defence in the end, but kind of anxious start that for Ireland, Fiona.
Yeah, I suppose it's finding their feet, getting to know each other around them. You know, there's a lot of inexperienced players there, so they need someone to settle. You need the likes of Maz Riley or Sophie Spence just to settle a little bit and talk to the new girls.
Because in contrast, it is quite an experienced Italian side. This team has been together for a few years of the guts of this team, at any rate.
Yeah, the guts, but like, there's a lot of experience. Across, they have a few new players in the pack as well, so it'll be interesting to see how this first scrum goes. Fine.
Oh. Pichada, Camerano and Batoni.
Just make sure
ready, Cole, because
that's what everyone engaged on.
Looking forward to this.
Looking at Italy, they've actually been scrummaging quite high in the tournament. I'm sure that's something that Ireland have identified prior to this game and look to take them lower in the scrum.
Set!
I think Sofia Stefan looking like she might be coming around here, but keeping it in tight, and that's a good drive on by the Italian eight. Pick now. And Stefan does indeed come in, but held up just on the line. That's good pressure from the Irish defence, might have been that. Routine again. They come in just under the shadow of the post now, looking to go a bit wider. Swing out, and they had an extra player there, didn't quite manage to use it.
Yeah, there was space out wide there, they headed a little bit deeper and got the ball out there.
And that's knocked on, much to Ireland's relief. So good Irish pressure in the end, just forcing that error.
Yeah, Ireland just need to secure this ball off the scrum, set it up and then kick for position.
We'll just go through a couple of those changes. We've got 2 debutants in the back three in Kim Flood and Liz Burke. We've got the unusual side of Neve Briggs playing at outside central, although she has actually played a season there.
Yeah, she's there 2010, I think, and also 2013 as well. She had a bit of time there when Lynn Campbell was playing at 10.
So Mary Healy
There must be a gap engage. Do not pre-engage.
Feed this one.
It's a new look back row as well across the board. Obviously Sophie Spence moving from second row to eight. Also Kira Cooney, who had predominantly got most of her time in the second row as well. And Kira Griffin going into her more usual position of seven.
Set.
But Tom Tierney has retained a lot of experience on the bench, so if this does get a bit tricky, expect to see those coming on second half. That's a good scrum again by Italy, who have looked the dominant force in that scrummage. That's turned over ball, so right 7 metres in front of the post is a great position for Italy.
They have a habit of wheeling that scrum up on the loose head side, and it's something that we need to be conscious of, and I'm sure Ailish has looked at it, but we need all of Ireland's pressure then to drive over on the right hand side to keep it square.
Suggesting that Amy Perret should have penalised Italy there?
No, I don't think it was a whip. I think that's just the way that they put the pressure on, so.
Bind! Set! Ready!
So Sarah Bartine to feed this promising position for Italy. It's popped out with number 8. They go to the left. And that's missed tackle there by sending an output. That's unlike her. Bartine again. Locatelli taking that one on. But that's going to be penalised. Ireland not releasing after the tackle. So very considerable early pressure by the Italians.
Sorry?
I heard you on the radio actually yesterday, if you want. I happen to know that you think that this is going to be a one score win for Ireland.
Yeah,
but no more than that.
You know, Italy have pulled out really good performance over the last number of years. They just lack a bit of consistency at times. Particularly at home, they're very strong. They turned up France over twice there in the last 3 years. You know, they just qualified for the World Cup after beating Scotland last week. So they've achieved their goal for this tournament already. So a win here would be huge for them.
Oh, that's a great take at the front by
Kira
Cooney. It was very athletic. Although it looked a slightly awkward fall, so I hope she's okay after that. Good relieving kick from Nikki Cahy.
Yeah, it's been all Italy at the moment, but Ireland's defence is standing firm.
Blue, it's your ball. Keep your gap.
So, Camerano to throw. Italian liners look pretty good so far, but that's there. Mary Healy is gobbled up though by the Italian back row. Irish pack get around and get good drive going. She managed to get the deck, I think, so should be possession for Ireland. And that's a knock on, I think. Was it Ada Sheegan? Couldn't quite tell, possibly Lindsay Peat. Situation complicated by the fact that Mary Healy was gobbled up there and unable to take the swim half position.
Yeah, it's that where you need the experience there to step up and take control of that situation. Another pick and go, give Mary a chance to get up off the ground to feed the ball back then to Nikki.
So just 8 minutes in, and it's been sustained Italian pressure from the outset.
I really love to see the Italian 15 Furlan get her hands on the ball. She's a very exciting player. She's having an outstanding tournament, so it'll be good to see her getting the ball into a little bit of space and see what she can do for Italy.
Yeah, she's making her 50th appearance for Italy today, with contrast to Kim Flood on the other side making her debut. So an interesting matchup. So once again, the strong Italian scrum in a good position.
It's interesting here, they've moved their... We have our right winger in, standing in the line, leaving the wing free. Oh, she's moving back out there now.
They've used Stefan off that blind side already in this game, and she's looking threatening here again. Better scrum by Ireland. Again, Stefan comes in, and that's a super tackle by Naupu. Bertin now. Goni trying to go through for Ireland, and that's Magatti. That's very well taken though by Alison Miller. Super tackle. Again, Amy Perret has penalised Ireland.
Not rolling away
after the tackle, so. Three penalties, I think, at this stage, just in the first 9 minutes.
I got it, yeah.
Italy opt to go to the corner.
Now, there was space out there for Italy, but it was well tracked by Ali Miller, you know, and she has the pace to make up that space.
Green, step again,
yeah,
please.
She's great to watch, honestly, Miller, I have to say. And it's great to see her back in the 15s game, where we get to see her, but unfortunately, we get to see so much of the 7s. So again, threatening position for the Italians. Go to the tail of this occasion, and it's taken by number eight, Giordano. Again, they look to go into the middle. That's well popped to the prop. Oh, that's a big collision there. Fucciella. Good pressure. Sophie Stent's getting a kick through, but it's just come to the Italian centre. Solari against Stefan. In off the wing. Constant Italian pressure. Again, that's good hands by the front row. Tony actually showing nice hands there. Again, it's a penalty against Ireland.
Ireland are going to have to be careful here. I'm sure the referee is going to show a card now if they're not.
Just be far off. Interesting to see if they take the 3 points on offer this time. More central position. It looks, yes indeed, Berrettin signals to the post.
It's interesting off that line out. They were 5 metres out. They went for a five-man line out with a drive. I think they should have probably backed themselves with their full pack in there for the drive, because they went so well on the other side a couple of minutes earlier.
So Michele Solari, the distinctive headband there, looking to open Italy's account.
Yeah, Italy will have to come away with something from here. It's been all them for the last couple of minutes, so they want something from
Amy
the pressure.
We'll bring this girl back in, yeah? Yeah.
Absolutely, and with so many... So many changes, Ireland yet to find any real fluency or rhythm. They look forward to getting a kick-off, getting out of this area of the pitch and look to establish some position for the first time in the game. Solari, as she got that inside the post, she has indeed. Froter with the right hand upright, but made it to give Italy a 3-0 lead. Just 12 minutes into the game.
It's important now for Ireland to get down into Italy's half, keep a bit of possession and play a bit of rugby.
So Nikki Cahy to drop off. She's it's normally Niamh Briggs as well.
Yeah, I suppose it's again building that experience and depth that you need, because if Niamh got injured and wasn't available, and we would need someone to stand into that position.
Oh, that's knocked on by the Italian second row, or number eight rather, Giordano. That's a fairly basic error, but gives Ireland the first opportunity to establish a bit of momentum now.
It's really important now that they get this from, so they should be conscious now that Italy are trying to get it up on the left-hand side and drive through them, so Ailish really needs support for the rest of the scrum to come over and help her on that side.
Have you seen much of Ireland's new caps in the back line, Tim Flood and Liz Burke?
Played club rugby with Liz Burke and played Leinster with Kim Flood, so... I know a bit.
Oh, that's knocked on by Briggs. The pass just was a little loose.
Liz had a good run in the club season this year, and semi-final of the league, scored 3 tries against Black Rock. So, you know, she has pace and has finishing skills. Kim Flood, Dublin Gaelic footballer, involved in the 7 squad there. You know, she has exciting talent. You know, haven't seen that much of her, obviously at this level, in her first cap as well.
Coach, ready, bind.
So Italy just bringing both centres over to the short side, leaving quite an attractive amount of space over on to the right hand side of the scrum. Be interested to see if they try to use that or kick deep.
It'll be interesting to see in open play who takes over the kicking duties with Siobhan gone, and whether Rigoni actually has a kick on her or not.
That's a better squad drive by Ireland. Much better scrum. Giordano gets it away, but it's loose. Berrettin goes back. And not quite getting enough pressure on there. But that's taken by Kim Flood, well taken at the second attempt. Shows good pace, great handoff. Good tackle by the Italian prop. Naz Riley now. Offloads. It's well taken on. Good ball by Efferon, first time. Kirikuni drives on. Mary Healy now. To Kahi. Out to Sophie Spence in the centre.
There's lots of space out wide now.
And Healy to Kahi. Good hands to Naupud. Lovely pass. Alison Miller, but that's well taken by the Italian right wing of Magatti. Healy again. Kahi, good hands. That's Lindsay Peat driving on. Good ball presentation. Kahi now again. Oh, Cooney just about takes that. Nearly a knock on, but she did well to recover it. But again, she's pinged for holding on after the tackle. Good pressure by the Italian, I think it was Solari actually.
Well, that was good by Ireland to retain the ball. We actually didn't make any ground on it.
Now Solari has seen space and has gone off. Very clever. Locatelli now. Oh, she doesn't use right wing Magatti, who might have had more legs. Again, Italy looking pretty sharp here today.
Yeah, they're here to play. That was very naive of Ireland to be bunched up expecting them to take.
Yeah, everybody turned their back on that one. Tom Tierney would be frustrated with that. Oh, that's a loose ball, but Giordano takes. Now Stefan chips on ahead. A tricky ball for Flood. She doesn't take the option of trying to get into touch, and now she's just 2 metres from her own line, and it's Mary Healy does actually get it back, so but there's no angle here. Kahi blocked down, and that I think might be a score. It was very loose, got blocked down, and then I think knocked on by Ireland, and then I think the Italian girl got to that just before the ball went out of play. So Amy Perret having a discussion with the
Susan Carthy's decision there.
Just say it again. So I've got pass back,
yep,
by Green, charged down by Blue,
yep.
And then did Green ground it at all, or was it knocked back?
No,
Green grounded it first.
Green grounded it first, before Blue grounded it. Okay, so it's going to be a scrum, 5 metre Blue.
Okay, no try.
No try, scrum to Blue.
It's going to be a 22 dropout.
Interesting that Ireland, it's an Italy scrum.
Oh, no, sorry, she's giving a 5 metre scrum. I thought she signalled for a 22.
Is there a ball then?
Yes.
I think what she said there, after the block down, there was a knock on by the Irish pair in the corner. I'm not quite sure who it was. And then it's ruled that the Italian player didn't get it down before it went into touch.
Okay. It's tough to see from this angle, so.
But whatever way you look at it, it's an escape for Ireland. And again, the strong Italian scrum is in a good position.
Again, if they look to get that up left.
13, that's a good scrum though by Ireland. Again, that's Giordano has knocked that on at the base. And they did exactly that. They got it up on the left initially and then drove through.
Yeah, Ireland. It actually suited Ireland. They went with it and then they powered through, so much better. They seem to have got the better of them now in the scrum.
Yeah, that's turned a little in the last 5 minutes, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's just remaining consistent now. They know what they need to do, so it's produced it time and time again.
Well, Lindsay Peat, I think, in particular, they're doing very well.
Yeah, she had a tough day at the office when she came on as sub against France and didn't make the match day squad against England, so giving her more time now against the Italians.
That's a free kick to Ireland for an early engagement by the Italians. So again, a sign maybe that the Italian scrum is getting a bit anxious. So this will be Niamh Briggs to clear up the line. That's a good kick. Difficult angle. Finds touch just 5 metres outside the 22. All this, however, really stemming from the Irish turning their back on that quick tap free kick that Solari took.
Is it short arm? Short arm, the ball.
So Cleaner Maloney, no, sorry, the it's Italian, so it's Camerano. It's a good line out. Bertina Locatelli Mary Healy in the tackle with Baz Riley. Baratine again. They've the numbers here. They choose to use it, but they don't. It's knocked on by the Italian second row, Trevisan. That was a promising situation there for Italy because they had an extra number. Sene Niopo takes the tackle. It's a bit loose. Alison Miller takes it. There's a bit of space here. She's through the middle. She's got pace. Hauled down in the end by the Italians, but this good quick ball here. Sophie Spence. Can she offload? Yes, she can. Ada Sheegan. Crowd's starting to find their voice. Mary Healy, Maz Riley on the charge. Actually, sorry, not Maz, it's Elaine Anthony. Apparently this time against the Italians for not releasing after the tackle, which is a bit of a change.
Yeah, there was good tempo there. Obviously, a pace injected by Alison Miller, then a quick ruck and a great offload by Sophie Spence. You know, obviously Italy got in there for the penalty, but we're not clearing out that ruck threat. So it is important that we clear past the ruck. Even when we do have quick ball, we're kind of stopping at the ball, meaning that Mary Healy has to go in between someone's legs to play the ball away. So it's important to clear past the ball.
So Irish line out just 15 metres inside the Italian half. One of the better positions that they've enjoyed in the first 21 minutes of the game.
Ireland going for a shortened line out here.
Has Sophie Spence played at 8 before? Have you?
She plays all her club rugby at 8.
Ah, okay.
So she would have experience there, all right.
That's well taken, Maz Riley. Lovely clean ball off the top. Nice pass by Healy to Cahy. That's Kerry Griffin taking that on. That's Cahy again. Ball hits the ground, but taken by Alison Miller. Very sharp.
Italy are very slow to fold her into the open side, so there is space there every time. So Ireland just needs to get the ball to hand, and the space is there.
Maz Riley taking this one on. Italy have good numbers in defence. Healy goes blindside. Sending an Upu. Just she offload inside. Tries to find Briggs on the inside, but that's knocked on.
Yeah, look, there's that endeavour to get the ball away, which is good. It's just the execution of it that they need to work on now. That's a couple of knock-ons by Niamh. Maybe she's just a little bit flat coming onto the ball. It's an eagerness and enthusiasm and probably just getting to learn Senny from playing at 13 as opposed to fullback.
Yeah, so Niopo is definitely trying to play the ball out of the tackle, which is high risk but also high reward if it comes off.
Coach! Point! Three!
Again, Italy pinged for an early engagement. Sophie Spence takes it, not sure, but she had a player ahead of her just as she tapped that.
She didn't go from the mark either, so, you know.
Lucky actually to get away with that, but so I'm going to use a set move now. Kira Cooney is the decoy to Cahy. Ada Sheegan now takes it on. Well taken by the Italian back row. Cahy again. Sending the Upo. And so he Briggs and uncharacteristically he's handling his area down a little bit today. That was she's trying to move it just a bit too quickly and it got away from her.
Would have been nice to see Liz Burke get the ball in that little bit of space that she had to see what she could have done. You know, I think Niamh is just getting a little bit too flat and putting herself under pressure then with the ball there.
Well, it's highly contested, but can't quite take it. Interesting to see Italy using their prop to throw in at the line-out. Oh, it's a big hit there by Kira Griffin. That's a loose enough kick. Alison Miller has a chance to run back. A chance she takes with great alacrity. Makes good ground up the middle. Mary Healy a little slow to arrive at that. Lindsay Peat now drives on but knocked on in the tackle. Just those little handling errors.
First and foremost, Italy are going to have to be very careful where they're kicking the ball. If they're going to kick it to Alison Miller like that, she's going to take it every time and find any little bit of space she can. There's really far too many unforced errors from this Irish team. Yes, there's a lot of inexperience, but these are just the basics that they really need to sharpen up on.
It's pre-engaged.
Okay, they haven't really settled down yet.
Okay.
Oh, no. It's, you know, 25 minutes into the game.
Just translating.
Okay.
Yep. There you go.
Once again, Italy stacked the short side on the scrum in the middle of the pitch. It's
Crouch.
It's actually a bit, you know, if it was raining and slanting wind, you could forgive the error rate, but this is actually beautiful conditions for a game today. Mary Healy takes Giordano, good pressure. Hiracuni in on it as well. If he get it away, sending Niopo in for a big hit, but the ball gets away by the Italians to full-back Furlan. Baratina.
Yeah, that was a good scrum. Ireland got pressure on, which meant Mary Healy was right up on the eight on the back foot.
Ada Sheegan in on the tackle there. And again, Rigoni finds Alison Miller, but this occasion Alison Miller knocks it on. So, and I don't understand why there wasn't advantage played to the Italians there by Amy Perrett.
I think her whistle might have just gone just before the Italian player picked up the ball. Again, that unforced error by Ali Miller.
Well, the unforced error wasn't great, but then she kind of casually kicked it away just to an Italian, which had potentially dangerous implications there. But
and again, it wasn't a great kick by Italy. Like, you know.
No.
Bind. Set.
So Barton to feed again. Away by Giordano, flipped away. Italy looked to move it out into midfield. Again, sending it over, good tackle. That's gone forward after the tackle from the Italians.
Yeah, it's kind of one of those calls. It's just on the line of being flat to forward, and it just depends on the angle that the referee is standing at, what they see.
Time.
The Italian out half, Petrus Rigoni, is normally a centre for them, so I think perhaps that's maybe explaining some of this. But kind of loose kicking, she's offered a couple up to certainly Alison Miller.
To be honest, if they're not in the 22, I'd nearly advise her to keep ball in hand and try and play it, run it out, because her kicks are just going to Alison. Yeah, came good because of an unforced error by Alison, but you know, if you continue to do it, she will get space.
So after 27 minutes for Ireland 0, Italy 3. Ireland have come back though from a highly pressurised start of the game to at least force their way back into the game, playing more of the game in the Italian half now.
Time on.
Running repairs there to Senna Naupo. She's a very exciting player, I think, Naupo.
Yeah, she has potential to open the game up a little bit. I'd love to see her give the ball a little bit earlier to the outside channels. Our players to run off her a little bit better to get the offloads away.
That's a better scrum by Italy this occasion. Sophie Spence feeds Mary Healy. That's a loose pass though to Cahy. And that's Kim Flood taking a little higher thought there, but there's no sanction against the Italians for that. Cahy now, she's got to step it over. On this occasion, she loses her footing. Healy now, she's got forwards down the short side. Mary-Louise Riley takes it on. Mary Healy to Sophie Spence at pace. That's good offload. Kira Griffin. Sophie Spence again, looking like an option, but this time it's gone out to Briggs. Again, she's just knocked it on. The referee has spotted that, and this has been an exercise of frustration today for Niamh.
Yeah, look, she'll be disappointed with herself, but they're not the standards that she has to be at, and you know, it's little things like that will let the team's head go down. They need the likes of Briggs stepping up, taking control of that situation and getting the ball back.
Exactly, with an inexperienced lineup, you really are looking to those leaders to set the bar for you.
Like, granted, yeah, she's playing out of position, but that's just taking the ball into contact and keeping the ball.
So Italian scrum just inside their own half. The blindside Stefan is hovering with a bit of intent there. That's a good scrum by the Ireland, and that's a penalty. Italy collapsing. I refer to my scrum expert for this one.
Yeah, she just pulled the scrum down, and Ireland were on the front foot. You know, the scrum is funny. It's 50-50. Sometimes it's Ireland, sometimes it's Italy. Neither have got on top, really.
That's a good ball by Niamh Briggs. So this is Ireland's first time to establish a real position in the Italian 22.
Yeah, again, they're going to the shortened line out. Look, I imagine they're looking to hit Sophie Spence in the middle of the pitch there. Four-man line out.
Come in, Ireland. Come in.
So, well taken, athletically taken by Mars Riley. Painan Upu. Sophie Spence up the middle. Really away, good offload. Elaine Anthony. Good Italian just inserted herself into that one. The clear out was a bit slow to arrive.
Look, that was really good play. Line out on the 22, hitting Sophie, great offload, but then not quick enough into the rope. Like, simple things.
Again, the Italian kicking is poor. Alison Miller takes that one. Missed by Solari. Maz Riley steps back inside. The pressure again. That's a better clear out this occasion. We're on the recycle. Nikki Cahy goes to Briggs. Briggs show and go. Good handoff. And she's away, but taken by Stefan. Going backwards. Well defended by the Italian winger. Maz Riley now. Again, the clear out. This time is effective. Mary Healy now. Cahy. Ada Sheehan pops her way to Cahy on the loop. Over the top. Goes to Alison Miller. Has she the pace to get around? That's good defence by the Italian right winger, Magatti.
In fairness to Magatti, she's marshalled Ali Miller quite well in time she got the ball.
Yes, indeed. Sophie Spence, good ball placement. Nopo. Cooney now takes it on. Again, the Italians have slowed that down a bit, though. Mary Healy to Niamh Briggs. Decides on the kick this time, in behind. Liz Burke, that's well taken by the Italian fullback Furlan. Burke, though, makes the tackle. Italy now inside their own 22. That's a bit loose. Oh, Rigoni just about gets away. Or Solari, rather. Locatelli. Recover that situation was a bit dangerous for the Italians. Rescue, locked down. And it's Kira Cooney. As she got the support, ball now left to the left. Maz Riley, Nupo. Alison Miller. Italian actually had the numbers out wide. So again, Ayla Sheehan. Ireland's most promising attack of the match so far. Healy now to Cahy. Steps back inside. Seemed a bit indecisive there, Nikki. Held up, but Ireland will recycle. Italians, two of them on the deck. Sending a Upo. Is she through? Yes, she is. But it's one tackle by Furlan. 5 metres from the line. Niamh Briggs in to secure. Sophie Spence. Kira Griffin with the ball. Feeds to Maz Riley. A little show and go. And she got support. And that's Sophie Spence. Using her power just a couple of metres from the line now. Ada Sheehan. Or Lindsay Peat, actually. There's Lindsay Peat for the line. Has she made it? Referee's arm is in the air. That's a try to Ireland.
Yeah, really good sustained pressure there. Italy had two players out of the game for a bit, but Ireland picking and going, and Lindsay Peat gets over for the try. I think Italy's lack of a kicker is going to cause them trouble in this game, and it's going to be their Achilles heel.
We're much better by Ireland, a more sustained attack with more fluidity and able to get wide and back.
Really good break by Sene Nupu. Well, it started actually from a good block down from Kira Cooney. Good break by Sene Nupu and a great clearance from Niamh Briggs to get quick ball.
So Ireland take the lead, 5-3 after 33 minutes. Niamh Briggs with a chance to convert. come back a long way for that. She's just outside the 22. But Tom Tierney will be more encouraged by that. That's first time we've got some real continuity and movement into the game.
Yeah, and it was good speed to the ruck, and I think that's really key to them. You know, they've given away a few penalties by not getting into the ruck quick enough, but you can see when they get speed into the ruck, they clear and present good quick ball, they can score a try off it.
And Eve Briggs knocks that over to make it 7 points to 3.
The Women's Championship is all still very open, and it goes down to the final weekend. England en route to a Grand Slam to go to France next week, similar to the men's team, but France in their way of winning that Grand Slam.
Well taken by Maz Riley. Now finds Briggs going wide. Oh, that's a nice little ball. Kim Flood, the Italian centre, is over to make the covering tackle. Maria Grazia Cioffi.
Yeah, that was good play. Again, good quick ball out to the backs. Bit naivety there by Kim Flood to stop on the outside. She should have stepped back in as opposed to being pushed into touch, but you know, she'll learn from that.
There's a sense of confidence though in the Irish handling after that score. A nice moment for Lindsay Peat.
Yeah.
She's a bit of a Gaelic footballer.
Basketballer and Gaelic footballer, yeah.
Solari now. That's a nice little ball popped on the Barrettine.
She's an exciting scrum half. You know, she's a little general of the team and keeps them moving.
The Italian captain, actually, Barrettine. Again, Rigoni. Oh, that's a good hit on Giordano by Kira Griffin.
Brilliant hit by Kira Griffin, and well in by Eilish Egan to get the penalty there. Kira's put in some big hits already today, you know, stopping people on the game line.
Once again, Neve Briggs to touch. Yeah, a little disappointed with that one. Didn't quite a little slice on that, and touches just inside the Italian 10-meter line.
Tom off.
Tina Maloney now to throw. Another stoppage. The Italians are shipping a few injuries over the last little while. And importantly, two of them were down at the time that Ireland scored. But this is actually a pitch that you need to get used to, isn't it? It's very demanding on the calves.
Yeah, I was looking at the Italian game they played in Bologna, and it was a bit of a mud fest, similar to the pitch back in 2013 for the Grand Slam. So, yeah.
And again, the penalty is starting to flow Ireland's way. Now, Italy not releasing after the tackle, and Amy Perrett offers the penalty to Niamh Briggs. She has a little look at the post as she's coming over. Interested to see if she thinks it's within range.
It is within her range, but I think on the wrong side for her. So
so again, she prods that one up the line. And Ireland just a couple of metres inside the Italian 22. Yeah, are they going to go with a full line out or shortened
again? You know, this was obviously an area that they had trouble with over the last couple of games, was their line-out. Onush pulling them in for a full line-out now. But they have gone to shortened line-outs. But because they're inside the 22, they're probably going to look to drive it, so that's why they have everyone in.
Yeah.
Sorry, six-man, Kira Griffin standing at 9.
And Maloney again, it's well taken. But that's then crooked in. And Kira Griffin was getting excited, beating off to the line. That's a loose one, really. Again, a very promising position as Ireland look to build on that on their lead. Still an opportunity to put the Italian out half under pressure. She's been charged down once already and has been a bit ropey in her kicking. Doesn't go to plan for Italy, but they managed to secure possession anyway.
Yeah, Esther, she's one of the most experienced players, cleaning it up at the back there. That's how they managed to get out of their 22 now, which is important. Baratine box kick, maybe.
Indeed, it is. It's taken by Liz Burke. Looks to head for open field. Well taken by Rigoni, the Italian out half. Mary Healy now. To Ailish Egan. Good drive, pops it up. Adventurously out of the tackle there. Healy now finds Sophie Spence. Ireland getting runners at the Italians now. Lindsay Peat. Again though, the Italians are in on top of that, and it's another penalty given away by Ireland because they didn't get anybody in to support the ball carrier.
Yeah, like Cliona Maloney was there, all she needed to do was blow over. She took a split second to the side to go into the ruck.
A certain amount of that though is the ball carrier getting, you know, taken around when they're just a bit isolated and not having the support there. So we're nearly at half time now. Ireland look like taking the lead into the second half. As Rigoni finds a good touch on the halfway line.
She didn't really go for distance there, she just wanted to get it out because it was in the centre, it's coming from the centre of the pitch, so a tough enough kick.
So Bertoni now with the throw, and that's crooked and knocked on. Referee's arm goes out, so it's advantage to Ireland. He recovered it. Mary Healy now to Ciara Cooney. Takes it on again. The Italians are quick to get in on that, but this time Ireland do secure. Lindsay Peat again, and that's a good clear out by Alison Miller of all people. Oh, Nicky Coy, that was a dangerous pass, and the Italians nearly intercepted that.
I would question whether Solari was offside there marginally, but you know, the referee didn't call it.
Healy now to Cahy. Lindsay Peat, she's carrying quite a bit of ball now in the last few minutes. Again, the Italians get in and up, but the clear out is affected. And the Italian girl had gone to hit the ground with one knee and continues to contest, so. Amy Pratt pinging her for
Cucciella, another experienced player, has been playing for a number of years.
Lee Briggs just knocks that one off the paddock, and Ireland will retire to the dressing room at half time, 7 points to three to the good. Yeah, the trajectory has been positive for Ireland off a poor beginning.
Yeah, you know, it was all Italy for the first 15 minutes, then Ireland started to take control a little bit more position wise. 7-3 ahead at half time. Probably just need to clean up those unforced errors, mind the ball in contact and clean out the ruck. You know, we seem to be talking about the same thing over and over again in every match.
So look forward to you joining us in the second half with Ireland leading 7 points to three at halftime.
We're about ready to We're about ready to rock steady. We're about ready to rock.
We're about ready to rock steady. We're about ready to rock steady.
So welcome back to the second half of Ireland versus Italy in the RBS Women's Six Nations, live from Donnybrook. Ireland lead at halftime 7-3. It's been a kind of patchy performance so far for Paula.
Yeah, I suppose to be expected with so many changes, new caps, different combinations. you know, I just think they need to stop those basic errors. It doesn't make a difference in combinations when it comes to that. They'll get a little bit more possession and hopefully get a little bit more go forward ball. From an Italian perspective, you know, when they have the ball in hand, they can look threatening at times. They just, that whole not having a kicker is going to really make them struggle throughout the game.
He probably dropped off. Take a bet, I can tell you.
Use it!
13, considers the option, it's going to be a box kick. Sophie Spence. He's going deep again, they're not gone. Again, a continuation of the frustrating errors of taking Ireland in this match so far.
Fast forward.
Yeah, again, Sophie probably wouldn't find herself in that position in all the long international games, but it is just a catch the ball that she should be capable of doing.
It's very exciting, it's the last time it's the first half, it's probably set it down a little bit more. It's looking fluid, and fluid rugby, but that's
Crouch!
That error there just sort of betrays that somewhat. So, Italian scrum, Barrettine to feed. Again, it's a good drive by Ireland, especially Lindsay Peat there on the loose head side. We're going to get it away, Rigoni now. Kicks ahead, finds a bit of grass. No, she doesn't. That's well taken by Liz Burke. And that's again a frustrating knock on by Ireland. Eve Briggs is just having one of those days with the hands.
Yeah, you know, it's not good enough. She needs to step up because the girls will rely on her to step up. You know, it was a great take from Liz Burke there. And I would have liked her to back herself on the outside maybe a little bit more. But she did go for the offload looking for an Eve. It'll be interesting to see as the game goes on whether many of the subs come on. You know, you have Claire McLaughlin there looking for her first cap, and then you have a lot of experience on that bench.
Yeah, a huge amount of experience really on the bench available to Tom Cheney, but so far no changes as yet. Again, Barrettine to feed. Again, a good drive by Ireland through the 90. That's
penalty Ireland.
Penalty to Ireland, yes. But they have the advantage, so Cahi moves it to Naiopu. Estuan, Eve Briggs, hits Kim Flood. Alison Miller now. Oh, that's again the Italian Magatti has done well defensively against Alison Miller. Cahi again into the midfield, Maz Riley. Presented for Healy to Cahi. Claire Griffin, Sophie Spence. Bats away the first tackler, but Locatelli comes back again. Healy now, and gone back and lost a little ground off that. Naupu pops it out of the tackle to Neve Briggs. We're going in on the tackle. It's a bit loose. Healy takes and does well to find Cahi. Chips ahead. But it's gone out on the full, and again, it's just one of those little frustrations for Ireland.
Yeah, look, it was probably the right idea. It was a bit disorganised. The space was there. It's just the execution of it. I'd like to see Nikki Cockey attack the line a little bit more. At the moment, she's just distributing, she's just getting the ball and passing. I'd like to make her be a little bit more of a threat herself to create further space out wide for the others.
That's interesting because she has definitely, she's got a good step, Nikki Cockey, and she does pose a personal threat. Although I think in the last match I saw her playing, she possibly overdid that, and maybe it's a reaction. That's Neve Briggs nearly on the, nearly taking that on the intercept and going under the post, but again, just a knock on.
Yeah, it was a nice little bit of play by Italy with the wraparound. Probably the wrong decision, the pass at that time. Neve was definitely coming up and read it quite well.
So the first 5 minutes of the second half played out mostly just in around the halfway line. The Irish scrum definitely getting on top now, and a scrum to Italy is no great advantage than you think here. Taps and Giordano looks to take it quickly before the drive comes on. Shows good feet, but that's a bit loose. Rigoni under pressure from Cahi. Sophie Spence in on that, but Italy do well just to get it away. Again, a full on, beats the first tackle. But that's clean, well in, clean and Maloney does well to roll away. Barrettine now. to Solari. That's knocked on by the Italian prop that was pretty loose by Solari. Ireland have the advantage now. Healy. Healy Sheehan through the hands. Neve Briggs sees some space in behind. Knocks it in there. It is Burke on the chase. Italian defender Stefan does well to keep that out of touch because it looked like she was dying with it and the Italians get it away.
Yeah, it was Furlan again who cleared her lines. Lovely to see Furlan get the ball there on a brilliant line and could see what she could do. She made 10 yards. Italy need to get her involved in the game as much as they can. She's nearly almost wasted a fullback when they can't get her into the game.
Thank you. Full line, is it?
Full line up, yeah.
Full.
So I'm having a bit of a conflab about this lineout. They're going to go full. Keenan Maloney to throw. Taken by Maz Riley. Hands off to Sophie Spence. Mary Healy now. Cahy again distributes rather than takes on. Sending a new book. Skips that out to Madison Miller. A good runner or defender this time, but the cover is across. She did manage to step inside McGarty that time, but the cover was across as Ireland recycle again and go up the middle to Sophie Spence. Ada Sheehan in for the support, but it's good defence. And that's robbed by Locatelli. Solari, Giotto. Again, just a lack of precision from Ireland. That's good pressure in defence. Baratine now. There's a little look. Sophie Spence looked like she might have been offside there, but gets away with it. Solari now presents. Giotto goes in to secure.
There's a lot of space out wide for Italy. They can move it.
They have the numbers there, but they can't get it wide. Again, they have the numbers. This time they have a better opportunity to get it wide. Furlan really should have let that one go first time. Took the tackle and tried to play out of it, but just succeeded only finding the head of her support player.
Yeah, it's error upon error. It's error from my Irish side, turns over to Italy, and then an error from Italy. Good attacking position here now for Ireland.
So it's currently fourth against fifth in the table, though it's last year's champions against the team that finished third. So you know, expect the standard to be high.
Definitely, I would expect higher than this. You know, particularly a year out from a World Cup, not many games, but there is a lot of changes. Italy are developing every year. Italy are getting better. You know, they kind of remind me of Ireland back kind of 2010. You know, so.
Sophie Spence does very well to recover that from a retreating scrum. It was a better Italian scrum that time, and good pressure again by the Italians in the counter ruck, and then wins on the penalty.
Got to clean up our breakdown.
So Solari finds touch. Tony throwing in. They've rotated their throwers between the hooker and the prop. Oh, it's well taken by Kira Griffin. Kind of snuck under. It was a bit of an underthrow. Cahy out to Nupo. Good ball to Alison Miller. Again, a chance to run it at McGarty, but again, McGarty does well. Miller might have used Kim Flood on the outside there, but he's taken into contact. Lindsay Peat takes it in. Cahy again, Briggs. Tina Maloney. Healy to Kira Griffin. And recycle again. Lindsay Peat taking her up the middle. But again, the Italians getting in, and it's happening repeatedly throughout the match.
Yeah, we resourced the first number of rooks quite well, and it was quick ball. But then it got to the sixth ruck and we just don't get in time. Christina Maloney looks to be down injured.
We still play. But no quick tap. Okay.
You know, that looked quite promising with Ali Miller going down the wing and came flood on the outside and then went to the other side of the pitch. You know, it was good possession, but then to turn over it so easily like that in the ruck is not good enough.
Certainly they've marshalled Alison Miller very well, and she's a dangerous strike runner for Ireland. But as the Italians missed that kick to touch, but they have defended very stoutly.
It was well taken by Liz Burke, good ground made on it.
Sophie Spence on the charge. Lindsay Peat into support. Tide. This is out into Briggs. Kim Flood does well. Can she offload? Not quite. Briggs secures. Mary Healy. Tide, that tiny defender, Solari, was up very quickly.
Thanks.
Putting pressure on. Again, a knock on by Ireland.
Yeah, Ireland definitely looking to get the ball out into these wider channels. They're looking to hit Alison Miller every time.
So Tom Cheney with the first of the cavalry coming on. Marissa Muldoon coming in from Mary Healy. And
yeah, Nora, probably game management might be a little bit better. She might look to play in different areas of the field than Nikki has. And, you know, it's a learning process for Nikki. As I said, she got her first cap out on the wing, so she only had four caps in the out-half position.
So the two half-backs being replaced, Nora Staple and Marissa Muldoon, who have been the fairly established combination over the last couple of seasons.
Yeah, I thought Mary Healy stood up quite well. She moved the ball quickly away. You know, she's a nice pass. It would have been nice to see her maybe taking on a little bit herself.
And same, as you were saying, same goes for Nikki Coy. You would like to see her maybe take a couple of balls on herself.
Just take a little bit of ownership of the position and be a bit more of a threat. Bit of messing at the scrum.
You two need to get in quicker, okay?
Okay.
Find up quicker.
Not quite sure what the issue is there, but the referee perhaps going back to have a chat with Locatelli.
I think it was Michaela Esther. I know she probably has the best English out of them. She spent some time, I think, over here in college, so she's probably the translator.
More solid Italian scrum this time. Baratin gets Pavlan away, chips it down. That's very well taken by Kim Flood. Tricky ball to take. Kira Griffin takes it on. And Esther is in on that and posing a threat, but Ireland do manage to recycle. Ada Sheegan now. Sophie Spence in support. Good care out. Nora Stapleton goes high and deep. It's well taken by Stefan. Good tackle. Neve Briggs on Furlan.
Hands off!
Now Rigoni again. Knocks one down. That's a. Took the ball, but Nora Stapleton takes.
Hold.
Oh, Furlan just managed to regather that. A great little offload, actually, as she was going to deck. Baratin just gets outside. Good hit by sending an open there.
Use it!
Baratin, so they. Punto Cucciella taking that ball on. Rigoni goes wide, nice spin pass. Solari, ooh, nearly away, but well taken by Kira Griffin. Knocked down by the Italians there. Quite a bit of continuity by the Italians.
Yeah. Far a bit of kicking them. All the game has been in front of us so far. Neither team really making inroads into each other's halves.
Time off.
Ruth O'Reilly's on now for Lindsay Peat.
That's Ruth O'Reilly on for Lindsay Peat. Ireland's try score. Tom Cherney starting to ring the changes. 54 minutes gone.
Good Italian crowd here getting into the game now.
Penalty to Ireland there for simply pulling back. Did you see what that penalty was for?
I didn't actually see it.
No. Oh, and Ireland missed the penalty. Furlan able to get that away. So the Irish line now just 10 metres outside the 22. And kind of getting away with that. Furlan's kicked it, not getting a huge amount of purchase on it. Trying a bit of movement in the line. Miles Riley takes. Stapleton now. Here Griffin on the charge. Alison Muldoon against Stapleton. Again, a sloppy pass. Alison Miller does well to recover. Muldoon now, Stapleton. Ruth O'Reilly into the game, first time. We're doing. I have a couple of numbers here. Nupo. Well defended by Giotto. Here Cooney now in the charge. A bit more go forward there. Taylor Sheegan looking to take on as well. But Muldoon uses it as a screen. Stapleton now takes it on. Doing again. Oh, and a bit of lack of communication between herself and Miles Riley. And now the Italians counter, and Berrettine makes good ground. Stefan goes into play scrum half. Coachella. And there's a bit of blocking there. Yes, indeed. Referee Brett picking up on it. So penalty to Ireland just outside the 10 metre. Probably just outside Neve Briggs' range. She's certainly looking at going down the line. And this time she finds the touch just outside the 22.
Come on.
So still scoreless in the second half as we get close to the end of the third quarter. Not really taken off, Fiona.
No, it hasn't. I suppose this has been Ireland's best position in the second half to look for something off. Great line out there.
Cooney feeds Ayla Sheegan. Better position now. It's not a great pass by Ruth Muldoon. Neve Briggs takes it on. Tackled by Solari. Muldoon to Stapleton. Again, hands to Nupo. Decides to crash it up. A good idea as Ireland get just 5 metres inside the 22 and really their best position of the second half. Elaine Anthony taking that one on.
No, don't play with it.
Muldoon. And that's good charge by Cliona Maloney. Ireland gradually making a bit of ground. This occasion has popped back inside to Ruth O'Reilly. Just 10 metres out now. Muldoon, Stapleton, pops back inside to Neve Briggs. Is she away? Not quite, but makes good ground. Muldoon now looks to go short side. Ada Sheegan. Ireland down just 5 metres away, and this is a better sustained passage of charging. But again, just that frustration. The ball pops out onto the deck from Maz Riley, and it's going to be an Italian scrum.
Yeah, look, it was really good continuity keeping the ball, but then back to that unforced error, knocking it on in contact.
Amy.
We really do. Ireland need to respect the ball a little bit more, you know, going into contact, ensure that it comes back.
Number 8 and number 13, Green.
8 and 13.
So yeah, it's been a free throw of the game. However, losing balls in contact and sloppy handling generally. A couple of more changes that Sophie Spence comes off, as does Niamh Briggs.
Claire McLaughlin on now for her first cap. She was involved in the Autumn International but didn't get capped that day, and then this is her first Six Nations game involved. So, you know, big game for her to replace Niamh Briggs.
And Paula Fitzpatrick also coming on there. She still has that that nose guard on, I see.
I think she's just wearing it as a fashion accessory now, to be honest, to be recognised.
As fashion accessories go, I'm not sure. Good pressure there by Ireland as the Italian back row looks to take it on. Furlan. Again, there's good pressure here. It's a tricky situation for the Italians. Oh, and the three of them trying to go in on the block down, but Rigoni actually did well there to make her touch.
She did. It was from a difficult position, the pitch. I'm surprised they didn't use the forwards a little bit more to get a better angle for the snake and make it a little bit easier on her. Or earlier, that Furlan didn't step in to kick the ball. I think Furlan's kick is probably has a bit more on it than Rigoni's.
Mm-hmm. It's still a good position for Ireland here inside the Italian 22.
Sorry, man. Back on.
Again, a shortened line-out. Kira Griffin takes up position just inside at half Nora Stapleton.
And Paula Fitzpatrick standing in the nine position, so they probably look to drive it.
Indeed they do. You know your stuff, you know. And a good drive it is. They've got some good momentum. A couple of bodies go to deck, but Ireland tried to keep the ball off the floor. As Riley regains her position and gets it. The drive on, but Italy have disrupted it somewhat.
Penalty advantage to Ireland, though.
Again, Ireland have to roll around the side. Muldoon now looks like she'd feed Fitzpatrick, which she does. Fitzpatrick almost away from the first tackle from the from Camerano, the hooker. Again, Ada Sheehan. She's driven powerfully all day. This is better ball now for Ireland. Stapleton goes to Claire McLaughlin. First touch in international rugby. Does well. Presents again. Quick ball. Neupo. That's good leg drive after the tackle, but I think she's held up over the line.
That was really good sustained pressure, using the maul very cleverly to suck in and create space out wide. Yes, Italy did disrupt it, but we recovered well after that. A good series of rucks and hard carries from the likes of Ailish Egan.
The referee's going to go all the way back over the far side of the pitch for the penalty that she was given advantage on.
It's a very long advantage.
It is, and to be honest, given that we would have had a 5 metre scrum, I would have thought we were better off where we were.
Very possibly. Then we'll kick for the line out and look to drive it again.
Amy, number 4, blue substitution.
So Ireland's best position of the second half. They've gradually been turning the putting the squeeze on the Italians as they make a substitution with Valentino Ruzza coming on at prop. She's replacing the second row, Elisa Pilotti. So Ireland again roll around. They've got a big drive on now here. Must score, you have to feel.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Amy Perrette, arm goes up in the air, and Ireland finally extend their advantage to 12 points to 3. Can't quite see who actually got the final touch on that.
Kira Griffin, possibly.
Oh, Paula Fitzpatrick, in fact, has been credited with the score.
Yeah, it was a really well formed maul, and then they got speed on it straight away, so very hard for Italy to defend it.
So I'm finally getting a bit of a reward for their second half pressure. And when Neve Briggs off the pitch, it'll be Nora Stapleton to attempt the conversion. Nice strike, right? Nora Stapleton. Flags go up. That's a fine conversion. So Ireland stretch it out to 14 points to 3 now in the second half. So a bit of comfort for Ireland. Game out to two scores. A little beyond your prediction, actually, of yesterday.
Yeah, I think Ireland definitely had the... I'm going to say the foothold in the game and then another unforced error.
Yeah, that was a bit of a catch by committee. There were about three of them looking to take it and just confuse the situation.
Number 2 and number 6. More subs coming on. Claire Malloy coming on now. This is the type of game she'll flourish in. 2 and 6.
And also Zoe Grattage coming on to replace Tina Maloney. And Kira Cooney replaced by Dan Malloy. An Italian girl is down. I didn't see what happened there because there was nothing obvious that caused her to go down. It's just a bit worrying. It's a good battle going on between Zoe Grattage and Tina Maloney for the hooking berth.
Yeah, you know, two new girls in this year, and it's great to see depth coming in that position. It's probably somewhere we haven't had a lot of depth in for the last number of years. You know, Gillian Burke's still out injured, so it's a perfect opportunity to build them now out for the next World Cup.
Do we have a pitch side doctor?
I think it's important that we see the likes of Fiona Reedy come on for Tighthead, and you know, Ailish is there, she's been the cornerstone of the pack for the last number of years, but we need to build the depth in that area as well.
So we have one? Because I'm not happy.
Hopefully she'll get a bit of a run.
And really that's what today has been about, isn't it? Just extending the depth, getting experience to girls that haven't had a huge amount. And
yeah.
A calculated gamble by Tom Cheney.
Yeah, look, the championship had been lost, so... It was using the game for another purpose.
Yeah, I want to get her checked.
There's no money in the game, like in the men's game, for finishing fourth or fifth. So there's no difference there. Obviously, world rankings come into play, but you know, that wouldn't have been too much of a concern.
Can we make a pitch side assessment substitution, please? The Italian said she was fine, but
I'm not really sure what's going on here.
Yeah.
Do it a nose?
I want to make sure she's not concussed.
So you want a head injury?
Yes.
That's the Italian hooker. Lucia Camorano. She's
going
got a bit
HIA.
Of a blow. I think it's a HIA, yeah.
That's a head injury assessment for people who wouldn't be aware of it.
She collapsed, so I want to make sure she's fine. If she's fine, she can come back on. Okay? Okay, I felt like she got dizzy and collapsed.
So it looks like Veronica Madia, actually no, it's Zangirolami.
They're actually, I think they could be bringing back on Batoni, are they? Yeah, they're looking to bring back on their prop Batoni, so.
And they're making a second change. Zangirolami will also be coming on.
Thank you.
He, I think, is the centre.
Coachella has played hooker before, so I wonder. Oh no, Batoni's gone in hooker. Okay.
Come on, behind.
So Zengro Lamy not on just yet, just continuing her warm up, but that change will not happen in a couple of moments. Good scrum again by Ireland, and this time they've actually heeled it back on their own side, but penalised not driving straight. As I hear Fiona Cochran and ex-prop go,
Interesting.
For interesting, I'm really interpreting it just wrong.
Yeah, I thought that was a bit harsh in Ireland now.
Dan Malloy getting into the game, customary fashion.
Ali Miller down injured there.
Yeah, she doesn't look in good nick there, Ali Miller. That's a worrying sign. Tony, so times go wide. Giotto, some good pass in there actually. And Stefan on the wing, but bustled into touch by Senna Niopo. And I don't like the look of this Alison Miller situation. She's kind of prone on the ground here, being attended to.
It looks like a neck.
On the near side.
No, that was well marshalled by Liz Burke on her first cap. She hasn't done much wrong in defence. She hasn't had much of an opportunity in attack to see what she can really do, but she hasn't done much wrong either.
That's true. I think both new caps, Kim Flood and Liz Burke, both were very solid, done their jobs well.
Yeah, we haven't seen a lot of them.
Haven't had a lot of opportunity, yes. One green short bind, so there's going to be a bit of a delay here, as it looks like a neck injury here to Alison Miller, and I'm sure they'll take their time.
She's sitting up now.
She's starting to sit up. That's good to see. So the Italian flanker, Esther, coming off. Alison Miller back on her feet now. I think getting asked a couple of questions, testing out the hamstring.
Okay. Look, you never be too sure what it is when a player is down like that. If there is any doubt at all, the referee seems to be questioning it to send her off for HIA as well.
Again, the referee looking for that swap you made. So
thank you.
I was erring on the side of caution. You can't blame them for that.
Yeah, no, a right call by the referee, you know. Right, interesting.
That's an interesting change, yes. As Fiona really makes her way on. It'd be interesting to see who comes out of the pack. Looks like Paula Fitzpatrick is going to...
Bit of confusion now. I think Egan. Claire Malloy is probably best suited to go out the back line.
It's Claire Malloy. I thought for a second Ailish Egan was there was a look of horror on her face.
She has got the pace, in fairness, but
so Zoe Grattage now to throw. That's knocked on by Italy, so we'll have a scrum again. So we had a difficult day with the darts on the last outing here against us, so she'd be a little unnerved by that possibly.
Was, and it was well up by Italy, the contest as well, which they haven't been doing for much earlier on. They've stayed on the ground for a lot of it, so. Yeah, so Ailish, Fiona Reedy's gone in front row, and Ailish Egan has moved to the back row to six.
So just 10 minutes remaining, Ireland leading 14 points to 3 because Larissa Muldoon feeds. It's gone a bit loose, Paula Fitzpatrick picks it up. Ireland look to rumble around the side. Fiona Reedy in on that, looking to get involved after just coming on the pitch. Yeah, good clear out by Kira Griffin, but that's nicked by the Italians. And Bertine looking to sneak down the short side, but again, the Italians handling us now has been crisp either, and that's starting to touch for a throw into Ireland.
Oh, it's such a pity, such perfect conditions, perfect pitch, and to have the amount of errors that we've had is really not of international standard.
Green ball. Green. But let's see if Ireland can finish with the first in these last 9 minutes.
I got two.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Liz Burke looking like she might be. It might be. Looking at a move with the blindside wing coming in. No, she can use the decoy. Sending Nupo through the middle. Well taken by. By Rigoni. Again, that's popped out, but it's popped out because Ahandas has swept it back on the Italian side, and it's going to be a penalty to Ireland.
Yeah, Rigoni got in there quite quickly, which is kind of an area of concern. She was a legal arch that playing it on the ground, but she was in.
It has been a feature of the game where we've allowed the Italians to insert themselves in over the ball carrier. No stable than finding touches off that penalty. Just 10 metres inside the Italian half.
Yeah, Camoli is coming on now for Picella.
What have you got left? I got about 10. Yeah, I have 11. Okay.
Yeah, 11 over here as well.
Okay, sweet. Come in!
So again, John will go with the short line out. Got it to throw. Again, unfortunately, that one's gone. Squint, as Bill McLaren used to say.
You know, that's difficult enough for Zoe to come on, and you know, first line out doesn't go well, and then they ask her to throw it to the back of the line out, which is tough. They are down numbers, they have three props in that short line out, so you know, they are limited in what they can do. But
she'd welcome a hardened load number two call, I think, so
yeah,
on the next one. The Italians go to the middle, it's good ball off the top. Take it up the middle again. So they have an extra number here. That's good carrying by the front row, the Italians. Oh, it looked like a high tackle, but I think that's gone unpunished. It's a nice little offload there, and Stefan in off the left wing. Oh, that was Fiona really feeding that handoff in the face there.
Paola's, I can't even pronounce Paola's second name, but it's number 22, used to be captain of the
Furlan again. Yeah, great little offload. Oh, knocked down. Bertine's been pretty tidy, actually. Nice player, but on that occasion, just fumbling it forward. Better play from the Italians.
Lack of fluidity, I suppose, in the game. It's been stop start, and
it has second half in particular, hasn't it?
Crouch, bind, set.
Just 5 minutes to go. Ireland looked to be getting the points out of this, but we want to finish with a bit of a flourish. We'll do it now. No poo. Just a break, but well held up by Solari. That's Riley now, wrapping around. Again, the Italians have big numbers here in defence. So Stapleton goes high. Again, Furlan. Been the most impressive of the Italian backline, really.
Yeah, she just hasn't got enough ball.
Yeah, Bertine did well there to recover that. Rigoni. Oh, again, just a bit snatchy by the Italians. The ball's like a hot potato there, but it'll be an advantage to Ireland with the scrum. Looks like Alison Miller has passed for HIA.
And likewise, Cameron Arrow as well, so. Claire Malloy will be happy to get back into the thick of the action.
Okay. That's Ada Sheehan off now.
Point. Set. Out.
Ready, ready, ready.
No.
Oh. Andrew well to get that ball away. It was a bit of a messy scrum. Oh, good break by Kim Flood. Makes it just up to 22, but that's been our most positive run of the day.
Yeah, great break, great feed from Claire McLaughlin.
And take the top penalty rather than go to the corner. Melissa Muldoon takes it on. Seven metres out now, and I'm looking to decorate the scoreline. 14-3 up. Not there to disable them. Claire Griffin takes it on. Nope. Oh, it's a risky ball. Well, that was stapling rather throwing that. Nope does well to recover.
Balls out.
Claire Malloy now. Rolls for an extra yard or so. Mary Anthony in over just to secure it. Now, Ruth O'Reilly. Fiona Reedy in over. Saved it in. Miles Riley now, but that's not much change out of the Italian defence over there. And this time I think it's been turned over by the Italians. So again, just another little frustration. They look to run from deep. And that's. We're running effectively from deep. Oh, but again, Rigoni just that ongoing frustration of the handling letting them down.
Good pace shown there by prop Guy. You know, she injected a bit of pace into it. That last pass then to Rigoni, not being able to claim it.
Yeah, good pace in the hooker, the replacement hooker, Lucia Guy. She hit that line like Sean Cronin. So this is somewhere between the Ireland under 20s squeaky win on Friday night on the landslide yesterday.
Yeah, I think Ireland will go back, you know. Yeah, positive getting all these new girls on the pitch, but go back and look at those unforced errors to step the standard up a little bit more before Scotland next week.
Set.
So perhaps last chance as we enter the 40th minute. Kim Flood again taking it forward on the against the grain.
It was possibly the wrong decision. We had space out wide.
Knock on green.
Liz Burke not quite on the same timing wavelength as the passer there. So Italy have a little chance to counter here. Not with passing like that, that's pretty sketchy. Fartine does well to fight off the first round defender. Steps back inside. Now Rigoni. Farnan makes the run for her, but she decides to take it on herself.
Use it!
Solid defence from Ireland there. Furlan. Nice little step. Can't quite get the ball away though. Alison Miller in on the tackle and does really well to rip it to turn that ball over for Ireland, but it's been turned over again. The Italians, but now. Claire Griffin did very well to find and secure a penalty out of all that back and forth.
Great work rate by Claire Griffin there. She made a tackle with a double hit herself and Zoe Gradage back on her feet again to get that penalty.
Nora Stapleman will just prod this one down the line. We're over the 18 minutes, but I'm not sure quite how much injury time is going to be, but we are possibly in the last attack or two for Ireland.
Come.
Come Crowd just finds Miles Riley now. That's a good wedge form by Ireland. The body positions and they can get a second drive on here. Claire Malloy emerges with the ball in hand as Ireland get to just 7 metres out. Stapleton across, ball back inside to Claire McLaughlin. Debbie Dunn does well there. Stapleton, they've got space outside and Kim Flood doesn't make the pass. Is that an opportunity gone to Begin? Ireland still have possession. Ball was out, so the Italian girl, 22, was allowed to come around the side there and put the pressure on.
Italy are down a player out here on the wing.
Yeah, and Ireland look just to finish this with a bit of a flourish to send the crowd home happy. Penalty given. Not releasing after the tackle. The Italians have been guilty of that on a lot of occasions today.
Kim Flood really should have let that ball out to Liz Burke in space.
Paul Fitzpatrick takes it on. Muldoon now.
Italy are down to 14 players at the moment.
Good call here, but no, that looks like it might have been turned over. No, it's a penalty given. And Larissa Muldoon stretches for line, but taken just short. There has to be a question as to whether there should have been a yellow card on that occasion, but Italy getting away with that. Numbers left if they choose to go this way. But that's Claire Malloy just going for the line. Held up again, right underneath the post now. Almost against the post. Referee decides it's held up. Ireland going forward. The scrum five.
Yeah, look, that's good work by Larissa Muldoon trying to speed up the tempo of the game, taking those quick taps. Chikimoli was down on the side here for quite a bit of time during that last passage of play.
So she's off now to be replaced by Nicoletti. So it's an inviting situation for Ireland here. Looking to finish off with a try. That's sending the open on the open side. Ireland keep it in tight though. They've got a drive on. Referee's arm is out. Fitzpatrick goes. But the Italian back row is all over. Claire Malloy picks, darts. Very close, is she there? I thought for a second she might have got that down, but hard to see from here.
Stop. You're short.
She's saying it's held up.
Back to the penalty, no, game over.
Ireland have run out of time. Don't quite get that try they were looking at the end. But do finish with a very convincing 14-3 win over Italy.
Yeah, you know, I think they're going to have to build on this performance. It was good. Those girls got their new cap. But again, as I said, standards need to rise. And we need to look at our execution a little bit more.
So a second win in the championship for Ireland. They will finish off with Scotland next week and hope to make that three. There's some signs of encouragement for Tom Tierney and some of the players that were brought in.
Yeah, no, definitely. And, you know, this is a process towards the World Cup and giving them as much exposure to this level of rugby as possible. You know, Scotland coming next week, I think Ireland definitely are the favourites.
So we leave it at that. Thank you for joining us on IrishRugby.ie. And I hope you can join us next week for when Ireland take on Scotland. We'll sign off here at 14-3 win for Ireland.